Hey, what's up, bike rumor fans? I'm here at the Ceramic Speed booth at Eurobike 2019 with a pretty exciting new thing. So last year they showed off their Driven drivetrain. This year what's new is a mountain bike version and the fact that they actually have a shiftable road bike version. I'll show you that in a second. So for the mountain bike version here, they had to modify this canyon. And normally it would be a 13 speed. This setup is 12 speeds because of some frame constraints. So they had to, you know, customize the frame to build this in and remove the thing. So a couple of quick numbers. They say the range on this will be about 450%, so not quite like the full 500% you get from an Eagle, but still pretty good, still pretty wide range when you have all 13 speeds working. And I'll show you a couple other things they had to do here, but weight-wise, they say when they added this, with the modifications they had to do to the frame and pulled all the SRAM Eagle parts off, it was about 700 and some grams lighter, but that's without any sort of shifter mechanism. They don't even have a shifter on this bike yet, and without the full internals here. So by the time they add all that stuff back, they say it could be about 200 to 250 grams lighter. So let's take a look at how this works. Basically at the back, you have this cheese grater-like geared thing that a lot of these little bearing rollers will integrate into. And so to make that work on a full suspension frame, you have to have two things happening here. This shaft has to be able to slide, the inner shaft has to be able to slide in and out, but also up here it has to pivot in line with the chain ring. So that pivot is going to have to be basically the same size to work as a fixed chain ring size. So I'm not sure how you're going to be able to change that one too much. So let's take a look from the top. You can see how those rollers integrate with the teeth. And the shifting part, of course, means this would have to slide and notch back to integrate in there. And similar setup up front on the chainring. You see how they just fit right in there between those teeth.
Cool.
So another difference with this drivetrain is the fact that the torque is being applied totally different. So they say with the normal, you know, cassette, the chain is pulling it that way and all of the torque is in that direction. With this, because it's up here, the pressure is actually going that way. And so the bearing setup inside the drivetrain and the freehub body is going to be different. And that's one of the things that they're still working on with this, is trying to figure out what they have to do. So you not only have to modify the frame, you potentially have to modify the way the rear hubs are designed too. Okay, but why do all of this? It seems like a lot of changes, a lot of things you're going to do differently. Two reasons, efficiency and aerodynamic gain. So we just published their aerodynamic test in the specialized wind tunnel and showed that this was massively more aerodynamic than what you get with the normal cassette and chain cluster. But efficiency-wise, so when they introduced this last year, the numbers they were throwing out were, if you look at a brand new Dura-Ace drivetrain, fresh out of the box, you're looking at about 97% efficiency. If you did everything you could do with their, you know, you can see in the background there, that ceramic coated or like wax coated chain, their pulleys and everything, 100% as optimized as you possibly could, you're looking at like 98% efficiency. With this system, the Driven system, you end up over 99%. So is it worth it? Well, it's cool. They say most normal riders may not notice a ton. You might feel ever so slightly faster, but really at this point, it's all about where can we find any kind of gains.
Of course, one of the things you have to worry about with a mountain bike drivetrain is contamination. And so that's why they set this covered system up on an aero bike. This one's reduced down to 10 speeds because of different constraints they had with frame design and everything else that they had to work around. But it also shows how they could potentially make the system even more aerodynamic and keep it cleaner when you're riding around in muddy situations. So the other big news from last year is that the system is now shiftable. So what you see here is a shifting prototype that they're currently charging, but we got them to do a little quick shift for us. The way it works is you can't just slide that whole roller ring on the back across the different teeth. It actually has to engage with the new cog as it's disengaging with the last one.
All right, so I'm gonna put it in the master position right here. All right, so this is now the leader. So let's say we want to do a right shift. Okay, so you see how it kicks over? Then this rolls through, and can you see the torque decoupler engage back there? Boom, it catches, rolls through. Come on. and then releases. Now you want to bring the slave over, okay? It comes through. And now let's do a left shift. All right, so go ahead and do a left shift, Morton. Oh, sorry. Thanks. Okay. See the torque decoupler back there? Comes through. You'll hear the torque decoupler snap back, and then do it, finish it off. And it's not good. Right button. Okay. So right shift. Okay. There we go. Perfect. Follow up. Okay. Solid. Through. Okay. Finish up. Let's try left one. Okay, left.
You can see the little wire port where you charge the system. All of the electronics are fully contained inside of the drive shaft. So it's a wireless electronic shifting system that will have simple little buttons up on the handlebar somewhere. Right now, this is the little remote control box they're using for shifting demos. Okay, so where does that leave us? This is something that is in development that they may or may not look for production partners for, but obviously they're gonna have to have frame partners for, because it does require frame modifications to make this system work on anyone. You can't just slap this on in place of a normal drivetrain. It's in development. They say maybe in like 6 weeks to a few months, they should have like fully shiftable, rideable stuff. Right now they do have a single speed version that they've been testing on the track with some pros, and it's promising, but you know, this is something they're committed to bringing to market in some way, shape, or form. It just may take a little while.